Hi, my name is Dong. I'm a Canadian animator based in Japan. For those who want to work in the animation industry, a strong demo reel and portfolio is the key to getting work for both freelancers and those who want to work full-time. I know many of my viewers are young animators who might not have industry experience, so I think it would be of value to give some tips and show you guys what I had in my portfolio and reel when I first entered the industry both in Canada and later on when I moved to Japan. I will have my old demo reel at the end of this video, so stay tuned. The number one rule when building your demo reel, and portfolio for that matter, is to only have your best work on display. When I was in university in Canada, I had animated two short films. One was a group effort with my friends, and one was a completely independent effort. And if you want to see them, you can find them on this channel. At the time, I was just about to graduate and enter the workforce, and I needed to put something together. My thesis film, called Halcyon Days of Youth, was my best work at the time, and I put it at the front of my reel. In terms of animation, it shows off my ability to animate a variety of scenes, including walks, runs, interactions with different objects, animals, and acting with dialogue. It's also very polished. Everything is really finished, and the inclusion of the background shows off my ability to draw layout, understand 3D space, and show people that I can paint. These backgrounds were painted with gouache, by the way, and I had to teach myself how to use that medium within those 8 months we had for production. I also put parts of my group film, called Dumbageddon, into my reel as well. I had animated some big action shots on this film, so I wanted to show that off. It is also in a drastically different style, which shows off that I can handle different art styles. This film was also pretty polished and I thought it would make a good fit. Both of these short films had film festival runs, and mentioning that I think helped me in my job search as well. These two films were the only thing in my first reel, and they helped me get my first job in the industry right out of school at the Canadian media conglomerate Corus. There, I was able to work on my first professional show, a little animated series called Wishfart, and once I moved to Japan a year later, I also added a couple seconds of that show into my reel on top of my two other short films when I was looking for work here. I'll talk about my job hunting experience in Japan later on in the video. So my demo reel only consisted of a couple polished scenes from my two short films and that show I worked on in Canada. Timing-wise, it was only about a minute and a half. And I think that is more than enough. In terms of length, I recommend keeping your reel at about 1-2 minutes with no filler. Remember to only put your best, well-polished work in your reel. Your employer wants to see amazing work and to see your understanding of animation. If you only have half a minute of amazing work, it is better to keep your reel at half a minute than to pad it out with mediocre work. If you feel any of your work is mediocre, take it out of the reel. Remember to also put your best work first. The first 5 seconds of your reel determines if the person watching it wants to continue watching. If you don't have any personal films or professional work to show, what should you put in your demo reel? Well, anything that can show off your animation ability. If you are subscribed to this channel, you will notice I put out videos on various animation exercises, and these are great to put in your reel to demonstrate your mastery of animation. You should be able to show that you can animate a walk and run cycle, and showing you can animate a horse walk would also be pretty impressive. Remember that hammer toss exercise? Showing you can animate a character handling heavy objects is great for a reel. Another must-have is an acting scene with dialogue. This will demonstrate your ability to work with audio, your lip-syncing ability, and your creativity when it comes to acting. Action scenes are also pretty fun, and if you have the time, choreographing a fight scene will look great to your potential employer. Some other things to take note of are to make sure you have a title card at the beginning of your reel with your contact info. And if multiple people worked on something, make sure to clearly state what your own role was. Music is not important, so make sure that it isn't distracting. Over time, as you gain more experience in the industry, you would slowly replace footage in your reel with professional work from more popular and well-known properties, as well as clips that show off your mastery of the animation. Uploading your demo reel on YouTube or on your Twitter lets you quickly send a link to it when needed. Especially here in Japan, where many animators are freelancers, having your demo reel be the stickied post on your Twitter page lets potential producers see your work quickly and will help you get work if you want to freelance on Japanese anime. However, when I was looking for full-time work in Japan, everything is still done physically and you still have to snail mail everything. I had to send in my reel on a small USB drive along with prints of my portfolio and resume. Speaking of which, when looking for work in Japan, I was asked to send in a portfolio of works, which I'll quickly touch up on. So what should you put in a portfolio? Well, anything that shows off your mastery of drawing. In my portfolio, I had a couple of illustrations with a character in a scene. Since in Japan, the animator also does layout, it is important to show that you can draw backgrounds and to make sure that your characters are not floating in white space. I sometimes do figure drawings from life, and putting those in are a great idea to show you can draw the human form. At the time, I had a yearly pass to the local zoo, so I put in some of my animal drawings in there. These pieces should generally be secondary to the demo reel, so put pieces in that cover up any holes in your reel. If you are at a loss, I recommend doing illustrations and sketches of characters and environments. In terms of pieces, I only submitted 5 pages, which several of my figure and animal drawings shrunk and fit onto a single page. Again, these are only there to help support the demo reel, and I recommend having quality over quantity. Anyways, I hope my experiences can help you in your own journey. I've been pretty busy lately, but I hope to do a Q&A in a couple months to answer your questions about animation and the industry. I want to give a big thanks to the Patreon supporters. Thanks to you guys, this channel is finally self-sufficient and can pay for itself. Links are down below if you would like to help me out. Remember, helping me helps me help you. Check out my social media, where I've been trying to post more sketches and illustrations. And I'll play my old demo reel now. Looking back, I could see that I had grown a lot, but this should give you a glance to where I was in my own journey at the time. That's it for me. Until next time.
This afternoon. What about the...
Oh! Looks like we're out of sugar. I'll go borrow some from the neighbors.
But hey, wait!
This afternoon, all right?